India, one of the oldest civilizations in the world, and one of the youngest nations. In just 75 years of its independence from colonial rule, the country has seen an unparalleled pace of progress. On this Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, we celebrate India. How we eat and pray, balance modernity with tradition. How we nurture science and protect our ancient forests. How we tell millions of stories on the big screen. From languages and spices to IT powerhouses and space travel. From ancient philosophy and ways of living to modern cinema and environmental conservation, the world has always looked to India. The journey of India is like no other. Dim the lights, raise the curtains, let the silver screen come to life. India loves cinema with all our heart. Our idols are the larger-than-life characters on screen, the superheroes, deities, legends. And show the world how the best stories are told. We love to make a song and dance about love. We root for the common man and rejoice in his triumphs. We hum the patriotic tunes that were sung at the dawn of Indian independence. Our history of film goes back more than a century. Yes, 100 years. From Dadasaheb Phalke's Raja Harishchand in the year 1913 to Alamar, our first talkie in 1931. From Awara's first ever dream sequence to our nominations and awards on a world stage. Today, we are the largest film industry in the world, making over 2,000 films every year. Our movies are watched around the world by people from different cultures and nationalities. Our movies are inspiration for the world's creative economy. Even when film was in black and white, our stories were always in Technicolor. Our silver screen, golden. The journey of India, a fairy tale without an end. Lights, camera, action! Let the movies begin.
Watching a film is like stepping into a multiverse. We are transported to different eras and places as we live hundreds of lives. We sell more than 1 billion movie tickets every year, produce more films than any other country in the world, a nearly 200 billion rupee industry.
The answer to the popularity of Indian cinema is something that I learned from my revered father. During his last years, every evening he would want to see a film. A cassette was brought and set up for him, and every evening he would watch many times the same film over and over again. And one evening I asked him, you know, what is it that is so attractive for you for wanting to see a film every evening? And he said, poetic justice. I get to see poetic justice within 3 hours.
But cinema to us is more than just entertainment. Our weddings, our fashion statements, even our dialogues when we're trying to charm a crush. They're all inspired by our silver screen heroes and heroines. But who brings it all together? The directors, the conductor of an orchestra, or the ringleader of a circus? They create the narrative. They make the magic happen. our visionary directors have put India on the world map of cinema. And so we let them show us the way.
Action!
Directors are like jacks of all arts and masters of none. We go to an extraordinary genius musician and we don't know ABCDs of music and we tell him how to do music. I can't draw for nuts, but I go to my production designer and tell him how a building needs to be built. Like in every craft, without mastering any of these arts, you are creating a masterpiece.
Most basic role is coordinating all the different talents and bringing them together around the nucleus of a story. That's the main thing. But more than that is how each department is handled and what is the vision behind it.
A director is like a poet. And if the script is like prose, it becomes incumbent on the director to throw it away and create a kind of a poem. Because from the poem, there is so much interpretation. And the director is the interpreter of the type on the pages. That's what a director does.
Directors are the master puppeteers, out of sight, yet pulling the strings to mesmerize the audience. Part gambler, part dictator, part parent, part god. Being a film director is like being the captain of the ship.
Cinema is where every filmmaker can play God because I decide when it rains, I decide when it stops. I decide when it thunders, I decide when it stops. I decide when I create a character, I decide when I can kill the character. I am God. Cinema makes me God.
Watching a story with 400, 500 people whom you never met, whom you probably will never meet again, but all of them in synchronization, feeling an emotion that the filmmaker is trying to tell you, and going through that emotions is a beautiful feeling that happens only in cinema.
Cinema is a reflection of who we are as people, who we are as a community, who we are as a country. India is quintessentially a family country. We're a country about families. So obviously we always tap into family dynamics because they're the most relatable. I mean, Dilwale was of course a quintessential mitti se judi prem kahani. But there was one element in that film that actually enveloped India with love. And that was the fact that family went back into the fabric of the love story. What it also did is, because it was about an NRI boy, it also opened up the diaspora, because it made it cool for even like the kids out of the country to watch that film. And it's still remembered as an iconic love story, also breaking myths, barriers, and creating an audience in the world. India has joy, it has happiness, it has celebration. We have large hearts and beautiful visuals, and we need to platform that to the real world.
India has boasted of some of the most visionary directors. Our roster of dream makers includes Satyajit Ray, Raj Kapoor, Mrinal Sen, Hrithik Khattak, Shyam Benegal, Yash Chopra, K. Asif, Vimal Roy, Mani Ratnam, Guru Dutt. The list keeps growing. These are the masters of our movie multiverse and inspirations to those outside as well. Sing Mera Juta Hai Japani in Russia and someone will join in, pakka.
Mera Juta Hai Japani, ye padloon Englishtani, sar pe lal topi rusi, phir bhi dil hai Hindustani. Avara
hun. The song Avara Hun was translated into Greek, Turkish, Chinese, Romanian. From Azerbaijan to Armenia, Somalia to Switzerland, Jamaica to Japan, our superstars' super fandom is without borders. The whole world is watching.
And if you get drawn towards Tiffany, you will spoil your chances of getting Nikki back to you.
Not bad, Dr. Jones.
Are you nervous?
What?
What is interesting, and I say this to Hollywood all the time, that, you know, we knew how to make movies before we knew how to use computers. And we are at that point now where India is almost a must-have on every big Hollywood film. whether it's a Mission Impossible film or a James Bond, Transformers, Harry Potter, Gravity, all of these mega films had more and more of their work happening out of India. We've got the capabilities, we've got the attitude, the passion, technical know-how to be able to do things that are as good as anybody else in the world. And beauty is that nobody knows and nobody can tell the difference. And that, I think, is the victory that you want. You don't want to be able to say, oh, that happened here or there. You want to be able to see the film and deliver what the filmmaker wanted. We worked with Indian stalwarts like Rajamouli. I think Mr. Rajamouli's tryst with using visual effects as a key component of his tool set in the way he presents films is absolutely fantastic. He really has, I think, single-handedly led the way in being able to deliver these massive vision, massive experiences.
When RRR released, I thought, okay, this is definitely not for the Western audiences, the kind of over-the-top action sequences that we have, over-the-top emotion sequences that we have. This is definitely an Indian sensibility. But response that I got from the Western audience, in particularly in the US, you won't believe they were crying.
Like, the West is going crazy. You have lead actors, lead members of the media, lead publications talking about RRR and how it's such a phenomenal syntax film. Indian cinema is finding its feet and in the way it's meant to be.
Our filmmakers are revered globally. Mehboob Khan's Mother India was nominated for an Oscar in 1957. Chetan Anand won the Palme d'Or at Cannes for Nichanagar in 1946. The list of international awardees is endless. I can promise you, somewhere in the world right now, an Indian film is captivating someone for the very first time. And it's probably by Satyajit Ray. Satyajit Ray, a name the world recognizes and reckons with. This poet of the silver screen won a Lifetime Achievement Oscar in 1992. Wes Anderson dedicated his film Darjeeling Limited to Ray's memory. And like him, so many international filmmakers still aspire to Ray's genius.
Ray is one of my masters. He's one of the filmmakers whose work I've returned to over and over again over the years throughout my life. And every time I see his films again, let's say Cherry Lot or Jalsaghar or Oprah Trilogy, once again, it's a whole new experience.
Okay.
I saw Pathe Panchali as soon as the film ended, went out to the ticket window, bought the ticket for the next show. And then after that show was ended, I went back and bought another ticket for the third show. So I saw three shows of that film the same day. Nobody had seen a film like that in India. And that made up my mind for another thing. I said, I must go and meet this man. I went to his home that afternoon. And this conversation went on until it was 9 o'clock at night. It was like everything, all my cinematic education rolled into one in about those 3 hours.
He's one of those iconic kind of filmmakers. The films are so good, each one on its own, and the body of work is even bigger.
Ray had this amazing ability to draw you in through stillness again, you know. He would draw you in by the way the characters looked at you. He would draw you in by the way the characters looked at each other. He would draw you in by just the rainfall pattering on the lake, on the leaves. But he would draw you in.
Just two cues alone in Pathe Panchali, where Oppu is introduced sleeping, and his sister opens the covers or so, and his eye appears, and you hear the sitar. This is something that stayed with me, and I think I do it all the time, my own films. I keep his films with me all the time. I have all of them. And when I want to be focused again, I go back to them. I go back to watching one or two of them. Some I haven't even seen yet, there's so many. His pictures seem to always revivify themselves over time. And this is something that happens only with the greatest filmmakers.
Indian cinema is unparalleled. The dreams are incredible, the sets are larger than life, the costumes are unforgettable. The emotions run high, there's sincerity, there's spectacle, and it is all rooted in our history. From the smallest village to the biggest city, performances have always been a part of our tradition. Whether it's mythological theatre like the Ramlila, or Nautanki, like Tamasha or Jatra. Our culture is one of storytellers. The Parsi community in India adopted British theatre, and it was a huge hit in Mumbai, with comedy skits, melodramatic performances, and poetry, which later became song and dance. In fact, the film Raja Harishchandra was first a Parsi play that ran for over 4,000 shows. But then, Ardeshir Irani made Alamara, India's first talkie. It had 7 songs. And suddenly, we could hear our own heroes, what they had to say, or maybe sing. Here is the game. I say, angry young man. And you knew it was Amitabh Bachchan. How about Tragedy King? Yes, Dilip Kumar. Kaka, India's first superstar. Rajesh Khanna. The man who can do anything. Thalaiva. Rajnikant. The Mahanayak. Uttam Kumar. The Badshah. Shah Rukh Khan. We cheer when they run in slow motion. We adore the way they flick their hair. We root for them when they're in love. Cry with them when they fail. We love the way they love their mothers. And when they triumph, we walk out of the cinema like... We simply worship them, literally.
What I think makes Indians crazy about their heroes, why do they worship them like that? I think that's in their DNA.
But when they decide that this star is my hero, and they submit to him, and they value him more than their own lives.
Dilip Kumar was very vulnerable. Devanand was very vulnerable. Shammi Kapoor was a musical giant. But we are going more and more towards the celebration of the hero.
Most of our stories have come from our mythologies and the roles that you read and heard in all our epics like the Mahabharata and the Ramayana. And in some form or the other, I've had a reflection on some of the roles that are designed for all these artists.
The hero fights for goodness. They are embodiment of righteousness. Be it NTR, MGR, Rajnikanth, Kamal Haasan, everyone, they stand for righteousness. That is why people identify with them.
When a hero comes on and he's able to solve the problem of the society, you start believing that that guy can actually do it. There's a ray of hope in your real life. I have seen films when I was a youngster in college come out thinking, if I see a bad guy, I'm going to wallop him. You know, because that's how powerful the films make you feel. Amitabh Bachchan did that. You know, the angry young man was one of the things that you believe that in society, if you have one of these guys, and Mr. Bachchan is there, so he'll sort it out for you, you know.
Whoever is playing the central character of the film tries to become an embodiment of what the writer or the director have intended them to be. So which is why every time you see us, we start looking like different people.
सबसे बड़ा हीरो जूने से जूना दिलीप कुमार हो गया
मेरा फेवरेट हीरो अमिताभ बच्चन है
इंडिया का सबसे बड़ा हीरो सलमान खान है
Shivaji Ganeshan.
Salman Khan, apna choice hai.
Sabse acha to mere ko Katri nahi lagti.
Meri favorite heroine Deepika Padukone aur kabhi kabhi mere sapne bhi aati hai.
India's history of strong female leads dates to the 1930s. Suraiya, Suchitra Sen, Vaijayanti Mala, Sitara Devi, Lalita Pawar, Fearless Nadia. These are just a few who blazed their way to our female-led blockbusters of today. And they were powerful behind the scenes too. Actor Devika Rani helmed India's first production studio, Bombay Talkies. Our heroines make every film unforgettable. Madhubala's smile, Rekha's oomph, Hema Malini's dancing, or the mischief in Kajol's eyes. Iconic. Our heroines bring more than glamour and beauty to the screen. They bring spirit, soul, and put the stars in our eyes.
My producer of Sapno Ka Saudagar, my first film, he gave this title to me. He introduced into the film industry as Dream Girl. You can see those days how Nargis ji, she used to perform even a romantic scene and also beautifully they were doing it. But with a very limitation, they were not just overdoing things. And that itself was very interesting for people to watch. And they were beautiful ladies. Nagis, then Nutan, then Meena Kumari, were always very sad. Then Mala Sinha, Sharmila Tagore, and Mumtaz, Asha Parekh. They came with a different look. They were very chulbuli, bright.
When I made my films, at that time, there weren't too many films that were women-centered. There were practically none. But you're more concerned about the central characters of women. Not as simply a mother, daughter, dutiful wife, not like that, as a human being, you know, whose personal likes, loves, all these things are important.
In Sholay also I got like that. First thing, she's a Tange wali. So first when this role was offered to me, I was wondering, Tange, ladki chalai gaya, aisa kaisa ho sakta? So Ramesh CP says that is the new thing in Indian cinema.
यहाँ तो बसंती का तांगा ही चलता है. देखो, मुझे बेफुजुल बात करने की आदत तो है नहीं. चलना है तो बोलो चलना है.
The role of the heroine was always reactive in the past. Today, I think your female hero has an identity of her own. She has her own struggles. She has her highs and lows and triumphs. I think there's an arc to her as an individual, as a person, as a human being, and that is the biggest change. From mother figures to schoolgirls, from divas to devis, our dream girls are sometimes the moral compass, sometimes an aspiration. One may support the hero or save the day herself. She may face inner struggles or lead her troops into war.
It has evolved. I mean, I did Bandit Queen. The character, the most prominent and the most strongest character in Masoom was Shabana. The strongest character in Mr. India was Sridevi. She was the powerhouse.
Women have always played a very important role in all our films. They've had a very powerful presence in our cinema. The mother, the sister, the bahu, the wife, their role in the entire scripting has always been very powerful.
The story of Bahubali, the story is run by Devasena and Sivagami, not Bahubali. He's not the proactive guy. He doesn't take lead. You know, Sivagami takes the lead. Devasena takes the lead.
Many of the heroines of today, like Alia Bhatt is there, Deepika Padukone. They are absolutely like today's girls, they are. And they are doing wonderful and they are bold enough to do many scenes.
You cannot deny that it is a work of all the women before us that has led us here. But finally, we were at a point where girls were saying, okay, I can have my own dreams. I can avenge the wrong that's happening in society. I don't need the man to do it for me. Suddenly, this was the aspirations of women off screen that was finding expression on screen. Indian films have always used music to elevate the mood, create connection, convey feelings. Once a week, the streets would go quiet as the whole country sat by the radio to listen to that show. Geet Mala.
Geet Mala ki chhau mein.
Babu samjho ishaare, horan pukare, pam pam pam.
Itna na mujhse tu pyar badha, ki main ek badal awara.
Aaja piya.
With the radio playing all day, these songs became the soundtrack to our lives. And we knew all of them by heart. I remember my favorite song as a kid was Mukaddar Ka Sikandar. Music makes our world go round indeed.
There's a saying called, a country is known from the music it listens to. What is the music that we listen to? Our main source of music has become our films. So songs in film has a huge, huge role and huge, huge influence, and it's a major part of our storytelling. We cannot imagine a film without songs.
The recall of a film is very rarely a scene, it's always a song. You always throw back your memory bank into a song, never into a scene. Scene comes after. We are adhura without that music element in our cinema.
In cinema, in songs, when we come to, initially they were poems, they were poetry. And the songs that we remember are all songs that spoke about us, spoke about our being, spoke about our loneliness, spoke about our existence, you know. We are very nostalgic in our, you know, in our sense of being.
Indian film music actually celebrates all the cultures, all the festivals, romance. It celebrates Indian classical music, it celebrates Indian folk music, it celebrates Western music.
Rahman was never part of Slumdog Millionaire. When we shot Slumdog, he was never there. His name was never there. And Jai Ho that you see today is actually shot to a Hindi film song. Aaj ki raat. So it is shot to that, okay? So in one of these days, we are shooting in VT station. We are all in the same car. Danny played 28 tracks that he, previous night he downloaded, okay? And he asked us to name the composer. Out of 28 tracks, 24 of them were Rahman's. So he asked, who is this guy? I said, he's known as the Mozart of the South. Danny, if you're considering an Indian composer, you should work with him. So when he came on board, obviously he wouldn't let Aaj Ki Raat go. But the genius of Rahman is that, look at Aaj Ki Raat edit and compose Jai Ho and fit it into the edit.
Our composers are like magicians. They'll take Indian classical music, Hindustani or Karnatak rag, add a little jazz here, some swing there, pop, rock, rap, and you get a film song that you can't get out of your head. That is uniquely Indian. Composers like Bhupen Hazarika took this one step further. His music promoted unity, like his famous song Ganga. And these songs were made sweeter still by legends like the Nightingale of India, Lata Mangeshkar. She transcended styles and even eras.
Lata Mangeshkar.
मंगेशकर की पतली आवाज थी, लेकिन पतली आवाज के अंदर आवाज का जादू जो था ना, अमेजिंग।
शायद फिर से जन्म में मुराद।
I consider iconic those who were originals. वो सारे के सारे ओरिजिनल वॉइसेस हैं। कि आवाज का जो टिम्बर है वो तो मुंह खोलेंगे ही तो आपके दिल के लग जाएगी।
मैं पल दो पल का शायर हूँ, पल दो पल मेरी कहानी है, पल दो पल मेरी हस्ती है, पल दो पल मेरी जवानी है।
म्यूजिक एज अ फॉर्म ऑफ स्टोरी टेलिंग इज कोडेड इन आवर डीएनए। मोर रिसेंटली यू हैव पीपल लाइक अरिजीत सिंह, सोनू निगम, श्रेया घोषाल। So I think we have a very rich tradition of singers and musicians.
The thing about Indian music and Indian love for music is that Indian music is all about feel and it's about the emotions. It's always going to surpass any other country's love for music.
You can use songs in enhancing emotions in many ways. That's what Indians have perfected or mastered over the years. Now I see many places across the world where even the Western audiences are saying, yes, we want the song and the dance.
You know how they say dance like no one's watching? Well, in our films, we not only dance like everyone's watching, we want everyone to join in as well. The dance steps of hit songs are like a secret code. Play it and we sync up. And the country becomes a nationwide flash mob. Big dance sequences mean massive, dreamy set designs. One of India's landmark films was Mughal-e-Azam, known as much for its incredible costumes as it is for music, dance and sets. And of course, leading the troops were the stars. Every star has a dance step, hook step if you please. Vahida Rehman's fluid movements, Shami Kapoor's head shake, Jitendra's jumping around, Chiranjeevi's Veena step, Madhuri Dixit's Dhak Dhak. No matter what the role is or the song, we dance.
Indian cinema cannot be without song and dance. It is very, very important because our country is full of so many festivities and so many things, celebrations happens, and then it is all different kinds of dances, all parts of the country they do, which is very rare in one country. So many variation is there. It was in the beginning, initial stage, it was Hira Lal Dance Master. He was very popular, very famous. He used to give dance choreography to Vaijayantimala, Padmini and all these, you know, very famous dances. Then, of course, came that Saroj Khan. She was the one who gave me a very, very beautiful dance number. In Mrigatrishna, I did one classical number, which is still today, I always feel that's the best dance which I've done.
I grew up on the magic, the magnitude, the magnificence of song and dance in Indian cinema. The fact that there used to be party sequences where people used to dance, there were like love songs that broke into lip sync.
Dance is an integral part of our culture. That's part of our expression. It's like for every occasion across the country, there is music and dance.
People ask us, why are there so many dances and songs in the movies from other countries? Because we are that kind of a country. We like to sing and dance, and we're absolutely comfortable showing that to the world. And, you know, slowly the world is following suit.
Filmy heroes and heroines make style statements, and we immediately adopt them. Zeena Taman's hippie style, Juhi Chawla's maxi dresses, Shah Rukh Khan's cool necklace. Our movie stars are the original fashion influencers. The Anarkali suit, Sadhana's fringe, Polka Dots aka the bobby print, Helen's feathers, Rajnikant's sunglasses, Allu Arjun's sharp dressing, Nargis's puffed sleeved cholis, And let's not forget who bought At Leisure to screen. India's lookbook comes from the movies. Did you know film costume designer Bhanu Athaiya invented the pre-pleated sari with a side zip? What would we even look like without films as our fashion inspiration?
If you see all our iconic stars, you know, starting from 1940s, you know, they've all just been so style-oriented. And not just vis-a-vis their clothes, their hairstyles, the way their mannerisms, the way they acted, you know. I think all of that became so famous. Rajesh Khanna's Nehru collared kurtas, or wearing a belt above a kurta, right? Mr. Bachchan's bell bottoms. So they were all very impeccably styled. It became a cycle of style, movies adapting from real life, making it even more fashionable. Zeena Taman, who came in and completely presented a new modern, you know, personality to the Indian heroine. And she was one actor who removed all the buffos and everything, right? And she made the hair more straighter, more modern, followed by Parveen Bhavi.
When I introduced Rani Mukherjee, I always wanted like a young Zeena Taman vibe. Kajal being a tomboy was actually an equivalent of Padmini Kolhapuri and Prem Rokh, who was actually in a totally different dynamic. My throwback was always to Hindi cinema.
भारत में सिनेमा निरंतर नए आयाम छू रहा है. वास्तव में फिल्म और समाज दोनों एक दूसरे के रिफ्लेक्शन हो. समाज में क्या हो रहा है वो फिल्में में देखने को मिलता है, और जो फिल्मों में हो रहा है वो समाज में भी आपको नजर आता है. हमारी फिल्में बॉक्स ऑफिस पर तो धूम मचाती रहती हैं, साथ ही पूरे विश्व में भारत की साख बढ़ाने, भारत का ब्रांड बनाने में भी बहुत बड़ा रोल प्ले करती है.
From Assamese to Oriya, Bengali to Bhojpuri, Marathi to Malayalam, and everything in between. Our movies come in so many languages. Each spark of brilliance is a story true to us. The themes, styles, and feelings cross-pollinate across regions, creating even more resonance. We have different faiths, but worship the same heroes. We speak different languages, but we sing the same songs. We are from different walks of life, but we dance to the same tunes. We all love a little melodrama, but we always want good to win over evil. The stories we tell all hold the elements of what make us burst into laughter or into tears. How we celebrate and communicate with each other. We are all stirred by representations of our struggle for independence and our more contemporary battles, whether at the border, like in Uri.
Indian army ne jang shuru nahi kithi, but we will bloody hell finish it.
Yes, sir.
How is the Josh?
Hi, sir.
How is the Josh?
Hi, sir.
I said, how is the Josh?
Hi, sir.
Or on the cricket field, like in 83, or in Lagan, cinema brings us together.
There are only two unifiers in India, cricket and cinema. You know, that's the common religion of the country. And when it comes to these two, it unifies across religions, languages, cultures, subcultures, everything.
When you sit in the theater, you don't care who the person sitting next to you is. Different state, different language, different caste. No, you cheer all along.
Every culture is separate from South India to East India to Western India to Punjab to Bengal to way up in the East. Cinema came, gave you four or five icons that everybody adhered to, everybody loved, and everybody wanted and respected. So in that way, it became a unifier.
एक बात अच्छी तरह सुन लीजिए और अभी समझ लीजिए, क्योंकि मैं दोबारा नहीं बताऊँ. इस टीम को सिर्फ वो प्लेयर्स चाहिए जो पहले इंडिया के लिए खेल रहे हैं, इंडिया, फिर अपनी टीम में अपने साथियों की, और उसके बाद भी अगर थोड़ी बहुत जान बच जाए तो अपने.
सिनेमा हैज ब्रॉट एवरीबॉडी मोर क्लोजर टू ईच अदर, by spreading a wonderful message all over about India, about our country, about our tradition, about our costumes. People are crazy about it all over the world. They love to follow us.
Indian cinema always has an emphasis on being good, and I think as a nation that's what we reflect to the world.
Jahan dal dal par sone ki chidiya karti hai basera, mere desh ki dharti sona ugle ugle heere moti, ae mere watan ke logo, ye gaane bajte rahenge isliye ki cinema is one of the most prime medium of entertainment for the Indian diaspora. Jahan bhartiye log hain, is bhasha ko samajhne wale log hain, wahan Indian cinema ghar ghar ke andar ghus gaya hai.
Cinema is a world of its own.
Cinema is my passion. Cinema is a vicarious way of living for me.
Cinema is our dreams on screen.
Cinema is a reflection of reality. It mirrors society.
Cinema is the reflection of society.
Cinema is art, and if we forget it, then we'll lose cinema.
So cinema is my life.
For me, cinema is life.
Cinema is life for me.
The cinema is life.
When the screen goes dark and the house lights come on, that's not where the story of Indian cinema ends. For us, the show goes on. We carry the music, the dance, and the dialogues out into the street. We replicate the poses and pictures in different cities and countries. We relive the emotions with our family and friends. In India, we honor the sweat behind the silver screen, the grit behind the glitz. Dunya ek rangmanch hai, aur hum sab uski katputliyan hain. Cinema is not just the world to us. It's the way we bring the world home.